Hi, I'm Vic Bearcroft, and the other day I was down at the Wildlife Heritage Foundation, a big cat sanctuary near Ashford in Kent. Amongst all the other big cats that were there were a pair of snow leopards. I love snow leopards because they have such a pronounced brow, such a noble look. So I've chosen this photograph, which was taken at extremely close quarters, as you can see, for the subject of our painting. Now, as always, I've started with a simple outline in soft pencil on the velour paper. This is done freehand, but if you want to, you can use a gridding system, or you can enlarge your photograph and use trace down paper, which works equally well on this paper. The first thing we need to do after our initial sketch is to establish an outline in black pastel. Now, the pastels I'm using for this are Conte hard pastels, and what we need to do is really give ourselves a strong outline before we start painting colour on the top. This will give us a support for everything else that follows. So let's begin with the important areas around the eyes, nose and the mouth, and try to be as careful as you can when applying this, using the corner of the pastel, which is the sharpest point, and carefully draw around the shape of the eyes and the tear ducts, of course, and get as much detail as you can at this stage. Establish position of the pupil, which is facing forward, and then some of the markings and the spots around the eyes. Notice that I'm stroking these markings and spots in. We don't want to do a solid spot, a solid lump of colour, if you like, because even though they're spots, they are still clumps of fur, albeit darker fur. So keep referring back to your photograph all the time and try, as you work around, to stroke the pastel in the direction of the fur growth. So sometimes this means pushing upwards as well as pulling away from you on each side. It's important to try and vary the angles on your strokes a little bit to make the fur look more natural as well. So we don't want everything in parallel lines, so vary the angles slightly. We can, in fact, just shade that tear duct in at this stage. And then coming down the side of the nose, we have some nice markings here, which help to identify the shape of the nose as well. Little spot just above the nose. And then we can just give an eyelash on this side. That's all we can see of that eye. And a little bit of fur just to strengthen that wonderful, bold, proud forehead. And then bring the black softly around the outside of the nose. And then we can deal with the nose itself, which is kind of a heart shape at an angle. You can see that kind of heart shape there. This is what we want to get. But don't fill anything in yet, just get the outline. And then, because we're extremely close up, we can clearly see the whisker follicles, where the whiskers grow from. Again, I'm treating these as just a series of short strokes with the black pastel, just to identify the fur texture. And then we have this wonderful black section just coming down into the bottom of the top lip and into the chin. Longer strokes this time. Little spots on the chin itself. And then we can come back and do the rest of the markings. But again, the spots vary in size, vary a little bit in shape too, but one of the most important things is getting the direction. Keep referring to your photograph, look for the directional strokes, and duplicate that as much as you can. We'll gradually work around the face and then come up to do the ears. Notice as well the paper that I've chosen is a light grey, and this helps because a snow leopard is predominantly grey, tinged of brown here and there, but the paper will help to give you an additional tone, so you don't need to worry about adding too much colour to it. A few little markings and spots on the top of the head, and this ear is almost out of focus, so we only need to suggest the outline a little bit. This one is more in focus. So we'll get the outline more correct here. Notice you need to be fairly sketchy with the ears because the edges are very furry. They're made of hairs, so they're not a solid line. When you're painting wildlife in pastel, try to avoid using solid lines wherever you can. Use zigzag lines when you're defining an edge of fur, for example. When you're dealing with the inside of the ear where it's deep in shadow, try to get a feeling for the direction of the hairs inside the ears. A little bit of suggestion of fur around the neck and one or two more spots down into the chest. And just let it fade out to the bottom. Remember, the important part is the face. That's what we're concentrating on, so we don't need too much detail on this side. And that should be enough, I think. Having established our black outline in hard pastel, what we need to do then is add some colour. So this is called the underpainting. For this, we're going to use ashby soft pastels, these round ones, which are suitable for velour because they're not too soft. And the first colour I'm going to use is a sort of dark brownish grey. And we'll begin with the darker parts inside the forehead. And notice what we're going to do is just use the side of the pastel, stroke very gently, again following the direction of the fur, looking for the dark tones in the fur. So we complete a section, then we can just gently stroke it in, just to blend it in and soften it off. A little bit around the eyes. Notice already how that light grey paper is beginning to work for us as an additional tone. So keep referring to the photograph, look for the darker tones, for the shadows. The ears, most of that is in shadow, so we'll use the dark tone there as well. And just the edge of that ear, stroking again in the direction of the fur growth. And we can come down the muzzle, a little bit on that side, a little bit more on this side, curve it round, follow the shape of the nose. Just give it a gentle rub, and then the mouth and the muzzle. Again, curving it round, imagine you're curving round that mouth. If you bring your pastel in line with that curve, then you'll get a much more realistic form evolving. And just gradually fade it back into the neck, a little bit at the back of the neck, and a tiny bit into the chin. Again, just go down, stroke it all with your fingers. Keep your snow leopard happy at all times. And finally, just a suggestion of fur growing out of the neck like that. And the second tone we're going to use is raw sienna. Because snow leopards are predominantly grey, but they also have a lot of yellowy tinge to their fur if you see them close. And again, we're going to start with the ears because I've noticed that there is quite a lot of sienna yellow, yellowy brown inside the ears. And don't be afraid to overlay some of this colour into the grey. Remember, this fur is one mass of fur, it's not individual layers of different colour. Around the side of the face, we've got some yellow tinges here, just coming down into the neck. Again, all the time stroking in the direction of the fur. This is where observation comes into play. When you notice how the fur grows, when you can see these animals up close, it's even better. But always refer to your photograph for these key points. Stroke them down into the neck, all the time blending these colours together. And we'll have a little bit under the eyes and around the muzzle. So we now start to have a three-tone painting. We've got the light grey, the darker brown grey, and the raw sienna. And just the application of this flat colour starts to bring everything to life. And that's all we need for our underpainting.